Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example 4.1 that is taken from chapter number 4, Axial Load, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbler, 9th edition. So statement is the assembly shown in figure 4-6A consists of an aluminum tube AB having cross-sectional area of 400 square millimeter, a steel rod having a diameter of 10 mm is attached to a rigid collar and passes through the tube. If a tensile load of 80 kN is applied to the rod, determine the displacement of end C of the rod. Take modulus of elasticity of steel is 200 GPa and for aluminum it's 70 GPa. So you can see this is tube AB and there is a steel rod that is passing through this tube and that is subjected to a tensile load of 80 kN. This collar is fixed against this support clear and the length of this tube is 400 millimeter and length of this rod, steel rod, which is BC, is 600 millimeter. So you have to determine the displacement of end C of the rod, that how much this end C will move toward right hand side. So let's start with the solution. So if you look that if this 80 kN is applied on this rod, steel rod CB, so clearly there will be elongation in this rod because it will be in tension. Clear? So I will draw the free body diagram of rod. So FBD of steel rod, so it will be like this. So this is, let's say this is the steel rod that is subjected to 80 kN load and this will be a tensile load, so 80 kN. Similarly, you can see that due to this load, this collar will exert force on this. As a result, this support will exert load in this direction. So this tube will be in compression because this point B is here. This point B will also exert a compressive load on this. So if I draw the free body diagram of tube, aluminum tube, so it will be like this. You can see it will be the same load, but that will be in compression. Okay, so 80 kN load. Okay, now what we will do is that we will first determine the displacement of end C with respect to B. So what we will do is that we will find the elongation in this steel rod. So if I designate this point as point B and this point as point C, so we can find the displacement of point C with respect to point D, point B, which will be equal to PL divided by AE. This is the formula for finding the elongation. So P here is 80 kN. So 80 into 10 raised to power 3 multiply by the length of tube. So the steel rod CB, and you can see this length is 60 millimeter. So 60 into 10 raised to power minus 3 divided by the diameter of this steel rod is given as 0.010 meter. So area will be equal to pi by 4 into 0.01 square. And E of steel is 200 gigapascal. So 200 into 10 raised to power 9 pascal. So when you solve, you will get the displacement of point B with respect to displacement of point C with respect to point B will comes out to be 0.003056 meter. Now positive sign, positive mean that C point moves toward right. Clear? Okay, so this positive sign indicates that C moves toward the right relative to end B since the bar elongate. Now what we will do is that we will find the displacement of point B relative to the fixed end C. So this is fixed end C and we will see that due to this compression, how much this point B moves toward this fixed support A. Clear? So we can find this displacement of point B with respect to A, or you can also say that displacement of point B will be again by using same formula PL divided by AE. So P is how much This is compressive load, so minus 80 into 10 to the power 3. Length of this AB is 400 millimeter, which is 400 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter divided by area. Now you can see that cross-sectional area of this steel aluminum tube is given as 400 square millimeter. So I can write 400, and if I convert it into meter, so it will be 10 to the power minus 6 square meter. And modulus of elasticity of aluminum is 70 gigapascal. So 70 into 10 to the power 9 pascal. So when you solve this, you will get the displacement of point B come out to be minus 0.001143 meter. Now we can also write it that displacement of point B is 0.001143 meter, and negative sign means that point B moves towards point A, because there in compression length is going to decrease. So I will write negative sign means that point B moves towards point A. Okay, here we have seen that point C is moving away toward right hand side, and point B is also moving toward point A. So what we will do is that since the both displacement are toward the right hand side, this point B and point C, so therefore the displacement of C with respect to A will be this one. So I can write displacement of point C will be equal to displacement of point B plus displacement of C with respect to B, and that will be equal to 0.00143 plus 0.003056 meter. Why I have taken this as a positive? Because this is moving toward right, and this was also moving toward right. So both are in the same direction. So it means that C will move in this direction, and that total displacement of point C will become equal to 0.00420 meter. There, and in millimeter, it is equal to 4.20 millimeter, and it is towards right hand side. Okay, and this is the answer of our this question. So what we have learned, that due to this load of 80 kilonewton, the C points will move 4.20 millimeter away from this original position. And that was all about this problem, example 4.1. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.